Wow, would you look at this? Do you know what this is?
It's a road, but not just any road. We're back on Route 66.
The mother road, the open road.
The very attractive road.
We've made it back to Kingman, Arizona on Andy Devine Avenue, or as it's better known to us, historic Route 66.
Last time I was in Kingman, Arizona, I stayed here at the Quality Inn.
It's an old Route 66 motel converted to modern usage, slightly upgraded inside, which claims to have played host to a number of celebrities, including Pamela Anderson.
It was actually pretty decent and pretty nice for the price, but I gotta be completely honest, I was a little disappointed when I stayed in this hotel, because whenever I'm on Route 66 and stay in any nice hotel, I'm always slightly disappointed that I'm not getting the authentic Route 66 experience.
See, Route 66 heyday went from like the mid-1920s all the way up till basically the 1960s when the interstate started to bypass all the old roads.
So whenever I stay in an old hotel that's been converted and has all the modern stuff inside, I'm always slightly disappointed, like I'm not getting the same experience that Route 66 travelers had back in the heyday. But last night, that totally changed.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the El Trovatore Motel.
Last time when I was staying over there, I really hadn't ever been to Kingman, so I checked in over there, I was all excited. Then I went to go to like Walmart or the gas station or something, and I drove past this, and my mind was immediately blown.
The first thing I noticed was this old, awesome Buick, and of course, that beautiful neon sign up there. But then when I circled back,
it was a different sign that caught my eye.
Look at this. Come in to see us, drive safely, yeah. Theme rooms?
All I could think is, I want to stay in a theme room, but the hotel was completely sold out both nights I was here last time.
Luckily, that all changed for me last night when I pulled in and checked in to the El Trovatore.
Look at this, before you even get down to the hotel, look at all the stuff out here. Look at Mr. Magoo here.
Stay out of the way. I don't think he's that great of a driver. All I could see is that sign for theme rooms and the big old school neon sign, the old cars on front. It looks like a ton of murals on the side of the building. And that tower.
There's just something about old neon, for real.
Any restored mid-century sign is pretty much guaranteed to pull me off the highway, but if that wasn't enough, the murals would have done the job. Look at this one.
This is the kind of thing I love so much.
Oh yeah, Route 66. We're going on the mother road.
Oh, it was so realistic.
Look at this. Look at somebody painted Route 66 traveling into this mural here with the Arizona flag. You got the El Trovatore over there. And then you got the Roadrunner. And what Roadrunner would be complete without a coyote?
And then check this out. This right here explains the El Trovatore.
Trovatore is Italian for troubadour or traveler.
Developer John F. Miller built the Nevada Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada. Today, that's the Golden Gate Hotel, the oldest hotel in Las Vegas.
He then moved to Kingman after the Hoover Dam was completed, purchased this motel site, and started construction. This hill up here above Old Kingman is called El Trovatore Hill.
And Mr. John F. Miller started with his service station right here.
Service station or filling station is old-timey speak for gas station.
Pretty smart move. Open up the gas station, start making a little moolah while you're working on your motor court down here.
This place dates all the way back to the 1930s. I believe the original plan, the building's actually connected right here and you drove in through the back.
But this is still one of the only pre-World War II auto court motels from back in the day, back in Route 66's heyday.
According to the owners, back when other hotels in town were charging, you know, less than a buck to stay in them.
Like the Beale Hotel that we checked out last time we were in Kingman, that hotel where you had to share a bathroom and you were in these tiny little rooms. Unlike those hotels,
the El Trovatore was charging around $3.
And that's because this place was super modern and fancy. You could pull your car right up to your room, and they had steam heat and air conditioning.
This place is now one of my favorite stops on old Route 66. If you look at all the buildings here,
you can see that they are covered with murals. Each of these rooms has a theme.
Over here, for example, we have the John Wayne room, which happens to have a John Wayne mural on the outside. Look, there's the door.
It's camouflaged inside of this horse.
Please don't open it. It hurts me.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Horse.
Oh, he's only playing. It feels good.
If you look closely under the Duke at his stagecoach, you'll notice the windows of this room are built into the stagecoach, so when people are in there at night, the windows light up.
Oh, watch out, Mr. Wayne. You got some arrows back there.
What's that? Oh, he's the strong, silent type.
No need to stand on formality, Mr. Wayne.
From what I could tell from the postcards, this here would have been the original entrance, and I think this was the original old office of the early El Trovatore Hotel.
Hotel is A-U-T-E-L, like automobile, motel, auto hotel. Get it? Are you starting to put this together? Wow. Up till a few years ago, like many other historic sites on Route 66, the El Trovatore was kind of run down. It was converted into like seedy little apartment units, so people were living here and all kinds of stuff. But then
the most amazing couple, Sam and Monica Frischer, purchased this place, threw everything they had into it,
and year by year have been lovingly restoring the motel and really restoring it to its rightful place as one of the jewels in the crown of old Route 66.
Just like something out of the movie Cars, they restored the old neon of the El Trovatore Motel,
themed all of the rooms, restored them, cleaned them up,
and have turned the El Trovatore into one of those places that you can't help falling in love with. If you love any kind of roadside architecture or tourist attraction,
it's freaking amazing.
It was everything I could do not to come here and film at least the outside of it the last time I was in Kingman.
But I held out because I thought to myself, if I'm very good, maybe I'll be lucky enough to stay here. And my luck, just like Porky Pig's here, was very, very good. And I did, in fact, sleep in this place last night.
Look at these murals here. You got Bugs Bunny as the sheriff, and then you got Olive Oil in the saloon there. Of course, there's Porky Pig guarding the Bugsy Siegel room. Oh, that's why there's so much money.
Oh, look at this! An old-timey tumbleweed. Oh, wait a minute. That's actually just an actual tumbleweed that blew in. never mind.
Side note, I just found out that tumbleweeds are an invasive species in the United States. They actually come from Europe, like places like Russia and stuff like that, and ended up here only when the cowboys started spreading across the plains.
That's weird. It's hard to picture the American West without tumbleweeds. My mind. Something's wrong.
Of course, it's all well and good to look at the El Trovatore in the daytime and talk about its neon, but what we really need to do is show you guys what this looks like at night.
Hang on, hold on. That tower here is 100 feet tall. That's 100 feet of restored neon. Does it get any cooler than that? See? It's like a whole other thing at night. This place freaking rules. This is like what Route 66 is all about. Husband and wife owners, a team that restored this place by hand, restoring all the neon, keeping it in repair. A piece of Route 66, no, a piece of American history come back to life.
I've been to a lot of places on Route 66, tourist traps and tourist attractions, and of course, tons of motels. And this place is about as Cars Land as it gets. This place looks amazing at night. Sam and Monica, the current owners, were telling me that none of the previous owners ever bothered to restore the old El Trovatore neon tower
after it was, get this, not making this up, not a Back to the Future joke, struck by lightning back in the day and burnt out all the neon.
Okay, nighttime at the El Trovatore. It's awesome, but maybe it's about time that we turn the lights back on, huh? Because it's kind of creepy out here alone.
Awesome, right? Now see, I knew that the outside was exciting, so I had no idea what to expect from the inside of the El Trovatore Motel.
I was a little worried about checking in, actually, because it kind of looked like maybe Cruella De Vil was running the place.
Luckily, this nice fella right here
convinced me that all was well, and I went inside and met the owners,
Sam, Monica, and their cute little brown chihuahua named Taco.
And they talked to me for an hour about
Route 66 and wigwam motels and visitors and Kingmen and all kinds of stuff.
Like literally the friendliest motel owners I have ever met. We talked for a long time because it was pouring rain. There was lightning out here when I first checked in. It was all crazy. So we hunkered down there. They invited me to watch some of the Olympics with them. They were so nice and so cool. And then Monica grabbed the key to show me to my room.
Now there's all kinds of murals on the outside of all the different motel rooms, including this, which purports to be the longest Route 66 map in the world.
Which we'll get back to in a second.
But if you look closely, those murals have nothing to do with the themes of the room. Here's Michael Jackson, we got Marilyn Monroe right there, James Dean, Paul Newman, who was actually in the movie Cars.
And then coming up right here, my room, room number 111,
right here with the Route 66 placard, the Marlon Brando suite.
When I get a room, I want to get the best room. I want to get a room to beat all the other rooms. I want a room that's going to let everybody know who's in charge here, who's the godfather, who's the number one aficionado of staying in it.
Let's go inside. Look at this door. Oh, here we go. The Marlon Brando.
I was literally so psyched when I walked in here.
Not only because they have an air conditioner and a fridge and a microwave, which seriously is the best thing ever.
If you have celiac or any kind of food intolerance, you need to make your own food, you appreciate a fridge and a microwave. No reason why they shouldn't be in every motel in the world. Just put that out there.
But Monica showed me her theme for the room. There's young Brando at the start of his career, the Wild Ones, and there's old Brando. It's your godfather.
Listen, when you want a bed and you need to go to sleep, you want a room that's themed around Brando. You don't want a room themed around Porky Pig. He'll keep you up all night. You don't want to sleep. Okay.
Yeah. Of course, the bed's a little messy because I slept in it last night. I just made it quickly for a demonstration here. But then, leaning over here on the table, there was some Kingmen information, a charging pod. This right here is another thing I wish they had in every hotel, because you got laptops, camera, batteries to charge.
This is my number one thing is like, where are the outlets, you know? Sometimes I have to move furniture and unplug lamps just to get an outlet for the laptop.
So that was a super nice touch. But the thing that blew me away was this. Look at this old-timey archway entrance to the bathroom.
Ignore my dirty towels there for a second. Take a look at this.
Now this is exactly what I was talking about wanting to experience what travelers on the old Route 66 would have experienced. Look at this ancient toilet right here. That's amazing. And look at this old school triangle sink fixture here. They don't make them like that anymore. Now, I know a lot of people would see stuff like this and be like, ugh, I don't know if that's the motel for me, but this is the kind of thing that I think lends itself to the whole authentic Route 66 experience that all those tourists from all over the world come to America to have. I know what a modern toilet looks like. I know what a modern shower from Home Depot looks like in a motel that was built in 2005 or something, but I've never taken a shower in a little room like this before. I mean, as you can see, it's obviously old. It's obviously a survivor, stood the test of time. Look, you got the handles over here and the shower head way over here. Look at that old floor tile.
This place is getting pretty close to being 100 years old. Pretty soon.
So it's amazing that some of these old school fixtures have survived. You can see the old tile in the wall still. So it gives you some idea of the amenities
that those original Route 66 travelers would have experienced at the El Trovatore.
Here, this window right here, which you can totally open. That's an old school window. Looks out on the train tracks. You can see the trains going by and looks down out at the mountains a little bit. You can see the sunrise out there. Awesome view.
The only really weird thing is this right here. The sealed up bathtub.
Now, Monica explained to me that the bathtubs are no good now, so rather than just leaving them as an open hole where people are disappointed by having no knobs to turn, they've covered them up. She's like, ah, you can put your luggage on there or whatever.
I know this place was apartments for a long time, so maybe that's why the bathtub's in here. I'm not sure if the bathtub was original or not.
What I do know is that the bathtub being covered up just makes me want to look inside so bad, but the lid wouldn't lift.
What's under there, do you think? A body? A porthole?
Narnia?
Actually, I've seen something like this in other hotels before where the old bathtubs were sealed off in favor of a shower. But this weirded me out at first because I thought that this was maybe a toilet paper holder, and it's obviously just like a soap thing and a thing for a washcloth, but I thought it was a toilet paper dispenser
until basically right now, so now I feel dumb, which is okay because I feel dumb most of the time anyway.
Dude, this place is awesome.
I pretty much came in here, started editing yesterday's video, and then immediately left a 5-star review on Yelp because even though this isn't 5-star luxury accommodations,
this is the type of place, the type of living history, if you will, where you can experience something of what people traveling Route 66 in the past would have experienced.
The only thing that's a little weird is this step right here, which when my shoes were off my foot, I rammed my foot into that really hard. And here's the funny part. I knew that this little raised floor was here, and I rammed my foot into it. And now my toe, my toes have a boo-boo.
Oh, and if their friendliness wasn't enough, as described already, I forgot to say that Sam gave me a present. When I checked in, he gave me this Route 66 pin.
Also, when I explained what it is that I do, he didn't charge me money to film here. He was like, yeah, go ahead. It's awesome. We love when people come here and show off our place.
They charged me $66 for the room, like Route 66, you know, plus tax. So it ended up being about 75, but 66 bucks for an authentic Route 66 experience and a free present.
He also gave me this Arizona Route 66 passport, which I did not know was a thing.
Somehow, up to this point, I've missed out on the fact that there are these Arizona Route 66 passports, and you can go to various visitor centers along old Route 66 and have your passport stamped from different Route 66 locations, and then I guess if you fill it all out, they mail you some kind of certificate or something at the end.
Wish I had known that earlier this year when I was traveling all over Route 66. I would have had my certificate by now, but oh well, better late than never.
I don't think this particular piece of furniture here is original to the rooms, but look at that right there. You got a wardrobe, you can hang up your stuff.
You guys ever use the drawers in hotels? I think when I stayed at Disneyland Paris for like 18 days, I used the drawers in a hotel. But otherwise, I don't think I've ever unpacked my suitcase and stuck the stuff in the drawers. Never for one night, do you?
Well, in addition to all that, they also have this closet here with the stick your luggage on it thing and some more hangers, and I don't know why, but this closet here last night was really weirding me out.
It has the spook on it. I don't know what it is.
I felt like a little kid again where I was like laying down here on the bed and I kept looking up every couple of minutes like din 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 din.
I don't want to sound like a wuss, but I literally got up and opened it and just left it. Just left it open.
You're not gonna make a surprise on me, Mike and Sully. Not again.
I just realized I put on the same shirt I was wearing yesterday. I better get another one.
Let's see here, though. Which shirt do I pick? This one? I don't know. That's so 2008. This one? No. This one? Oh, this is a good one.
Yeah, that one will do nicely.
There you go. I wear like a haunted man. You come to me on this, the day of my El Trovatore, and you ask me, what shirt should I wear?
Pretty much the worst Brando impersonation ever. Sorry, big guy. Sorry.
That's pretty much it. The El Trovatore Motel, Marlon Brando Suite Edition.
Put the luggage away here. Look at that. That's my tub of food. There's my portable stove. I got my first aid kit, my flashlight.
When you have dietary restrictions,
it's best to do as the Boy Scouts do and be prepared for anything.
I would definitely go ahead and say, without hesitation,
this is the best Route 66 motel I have ever stayed at. That's not hyperbole, I'm not exaggerating.
Even if I didn't love the place, which I really honestly do,
the way that I was greeted and treated by the people who own the place, and just seeing their passion and how much they love people coming to their motel and having fun on Route 66,
instantly made me fall in love with this place. Look at this right here, for example. Sam's Gas, the owner's name is Sam. Monica's Ice Cream, that's his wife right there.
I mean, I'm not saying she looks just like Betty Boop here. Busty Betty Boop.
But things like that right there, that's so cool. What a personal touch there. Underneath the old mighty El Trovatore Neon Tower. Apparently this is a suite, the Andy Devine Suite.
Well, I want to stay in the Andy Devine Suite. It sounds pretty sweet.
Sorry, I just wanted to keep repeating that sweet, sweet word.
This trips me out, this right here, the old office.
I know at one point the El Trovatore had a cafe and a bar, so I don't know if this would have served as
either one of those or if it would have been one of the other buildings up here.
Speaking of the Quality Inn that I stayed at before, which is on the same hill, John F. Miller owned the entire hill. So that apparently was a later addition to El Trovatore at one point. It dominated the whole hilltop.
Now back behind the current El Trovatore Motel, there's still some long-term housing back there, and you can see this older, unrestored portion of the motel still has what look like garages next to some of the old rooms.
A lot of those early motor court motels would have a garage next to the room. That was one of the early features of motels to begin with.
But since that feature really meant nothing to most people, especially out in a climate like this where you're really not gonna get that much snow or rain,
most of those old motel owners got smart and just converted the garage into extra rooms.
All right, as much as I want to explore more El Trovatore history, it is time for me to be going. But first, we have to explore the world's longest Route 66 map.
Over the decades, there have been several world's longest Route 66 maps, all of them in mural form, and this one at the El Trovatore purports to be the current champion.
At 206 feet, I would think it has a pretty good shot, right, monkey boy?
See, look at that. Special today. 206-foot map. Just what I was hankering for.
It actually starts back here on one of the back buildings where Route 66 starts, in Chicago, then winds its way along the fence over to this mural about the mural on the mural.
Well, that's a brain buster.
Then the highway turns the corner alongside all of the themed rooms.
You got St. Louis here and the Mississippi River, the Tasmanian Devil,
Carthage and Joplin, Missouri, and what's up, Doc? We got Kansas at Baxter Springs, and there's a little tiny gas station right there, Helena. Ooh. I love all these Route 66 shields.
These are all different Route 66 landmarks. I really like, by the way, all the hand-painted details of this.
Tulsa, Oklahoma, Tweety boy, we got Oklahoma City there. My, it looks so pretty.
Here's something for you. There was a lot of traffic on Route 66 during World War II. Soldiers moving back and forth across the country and equipment and all the Rosie the Riveters traveling everywhere. And this is a little throwback, Kilroy.
Moving on through Oklahoma, we have a twister there. Elk City, we've been there. Shamrock, Texas, oh, now we're into Texas. Goodbye, Marlon Brando, sweet.
Tomater's legless cousin here.
More Texas with Amarillo, Daffy Duck, Vega, Tucumcari, now we're all the way into New Mexico.
1,000 motel rooms in Tucumcari. I actually can't wait to go back there. If you've never seen it, I got a whole playlist on this channel of Route 66 videos, so go back and watch them if you have a chance.
Of course, the most famous thing about New Mexico, other than Albuquerque, is UFOs.
Roswell isn't on Route 66, but Roswell is super awesome, and I've done videos there before on my other channel, so I'm gonna go ahead and allow this.
Mm-hmm. Plus, the last time I was on Route 66, I'm pretty sure I saw what other people say is a UFO, so just putting that out there. Not even kidding, either.
We got the Continental Divide in New Mexico, and then we've got Arizona.
I love how the Roadrunner and the Coyote start Arizona. That's very appropriate.
Meep meep.
By the way, all these rooms have these little patio chairs out front, pretty cool. Anyway, we go through Arizona to Holbrook there, Flagstaff, the Grand Canyon, Seligman.
And then, of course, you are here, Kingman.
They worked in their own El Trovatore Tower, as they should. Then we got Oatman with the donkeys, you guys remember them.
And then Suffering Succotash, we crossed the Colorado River into California.
Got Barstow there, San Bernardino, and then the end of the road, Santa Monica.
Now, personally, because I live in Southern California, somewhat near to Santa Monica, I always think of Route 66 starting here and going that way. And that's really the way this mural is, because here's the office, there's Santa Monica, and the mural goes this way. So I appreciate that. But we went in backwards order just because that's what you're supposed to do, I guess.
When Route 66 began, almost all the traffic was coming from Chicago to LA.
But now that LA is a big giant metropolis in its own right, I mean, I think 10% of the country's population lives in California, right?
I don't know though, we need to be that strict anymore about which way Route 66 goes.
Oh, and by the way, Cruella DeVille's car, that's Sam's car right there, the owner's car. This was apparently his 50th birthday present. It's pretty awesome.
That thing is a doozy. Doesn't look very safe in the event of a crash, but it does look very sexy. All right, that's it for the world's longest Route 66 map. Time to go. I will say, by the way, that this guy, when I was walking around at night, really weirded me out.
Nice to have built-in security though, right?
Yep, this place is awesome. From me, it gets 5 stars for adventure, for authenticity. And not only would I stay here again, I definitely will stay here again, and I highly recommend that if you want a piece of original Route 66 flavor,
you should stay here too.
Yeah.
I should probably mention at this point
that I was the last to check in, so I actually had the last pick of rooms, and they're restoring these rooms one by one by one. So there are rooms that have like really nice wood flooring in them and more theming, which I 100% am excited to show you guys on my return. Speaking of returns, I was kind of hoping to return to Seligman, Arizona today and take a little bite out of that Route 66 experience again. There's an old-timey Route 66 way of getting to Seligman from Kingman that goes through towns I've never been through, but this time I'm actually not going that way because by nightfall tonight, I have to reach a certain destination for tomorrow's video. Pretty excited about it, but first I have to pick something up from McDonald's. I recently found out that McDonald's shakes are gluten-free. And since it's like a billion degrees outside, I'm going to indulge. Oh, that's frosty. Nom 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 nom. You know what's weird is when you're driving along on a sunny Arizona day and all of a sudden, it starts raining. Kinda hard. While the sun is still shining. That's a fun one. Dang, it really starts pouring all of a sudden. Now there's hail, and the interstate is flooded, and then it completely stops. Weird. Oh, sweet, check this out. Look at that, the rain is doing wonders for Northern Arizona. No, no, no. Look out there on the hills. Do you see right out there on the side of the hill? Do you see the letter S out there? That S means we're almost there. We're almost to one of my favorite places on earth. You might as well add an R in front of that S because it's the closest thing to Radiator Springs that you can really get to in real life. That S out there means we are close to Seligman. Just down there is the ultimate Route 66 town. But look, 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 look what I just saw. See the deer out there? The deer right by the cows. They're all staring at me. Hello, dear. Hello. What's for dinner, dear? Nothing. That's cute. It's gorgeous. It's cheering me up because yesterday, right before I got to Kingman, I was standing outside the car and there was all this wind, like a crazy windstorm, and lightning and thunder was starting. And this huge chunk of something, dust or sand or whatever, flew into my eye. It seemed okay last night, but now it's getting all red and itchy. And I was just stressing out right now, like, I hope it doesn't get infected or anything. And then I saw Bambi. Just look at that scene out there. That's gorgeous. I feel better now. Now if I go blind, you know, I'll have something to remember. Yes, Seligman, yes! I love Seligman because it's one of those places that turn from a little old western town to a classic Route 66 boomtown, then to a ghost town, to one of, if not the greatest, tourist towns on Route 66. Just, watch your children. And probably the best place ever to get a Route 66 souvenir. Whew, talk about power of the Cobra. See, people come from all over the world. France, England, Germany, Anaheim. There was this book about Route 66 I was gonna buy on Amazon, but I thought to myself, self, just wait, you'll probably be back out there soon and then you can buy it from one of those mom and pop stores. And I did wait and I did buy it from one of those mom and pop stores. See, I obeyed the sign. See, people always ask me how I know all the random stuff that I know, and it's because in between filming and editing and editing and filming and editing and editing and editing and doing some filming and doing some more editing, I'm usually reading books. Parents, please force your children to read. I've noticed that it's really difficult for an adult to become a strong reader, so you have to force kids to read so that they can actually enjoy reading later. But it's really important that you find things for them to read that they're interested in. I don't even care if it's just comic books. Reading is reading. Maybe you are a kid and you hate reading. Believe me, I know it's frustrating now. Like, hey, read for 30 minutes. Seems, oh, so boring. I want to play video games. But trust me, later you'll appreciate the fact that you're able to read and you're able to go into books and find out all this cool stuff. And all your friends are like, what? I never heard of that. I'm picking my nose. There it is. Juan Delgadillo's famous snow cap restaurant right there. Delicious. They don't have gluten-free food for me, but they do serve thousands of travelers from all over the world. There's a bunch of Australians over there, a bunch of Germans, and all I've ever seen here are smiling faces, so you know it's good. They got lots of options here. This place was built out of scrap lumber by Juan Delgadillo, the brother of Angel Delgadillo, who we met here on a previous visit to Seligman. Later it became one of a chain of snow cap places, which all went out of business, but this place kept the name. What was the secret of their longevity?
Probably the dead chicken. I'm gonna go ahead and go with that.
Plus, it doesn't hurt to be the official malt shop of Santa Claus.
No-legged Santa Claus, even.
Oh. He just never gives up. He's gonna get those presents to the children, no matter what happens to him.
My favorite part about the snow cap are the outhouses here, which are actually, you know, working real flushing toilets and sinks and stuff in outhouses, outside.
So funny, there's this double outhouse here and then there's a third one back behind it. I like this sign right there. I need that on my outhouse.
What I tell you about Radiator Springs, huh? Pretty good.
I love this place. I love that it's still family owned. I love that it's kitschy and cheesy and fun. If I could afford to buy a house to live in sometimes in Seligman, I would do it. It's the sometimes house. Yeah, Airbnb, now featuring Justin Skard's sometimes house. I can see it all now. My guests could stay in the Julio suite. I like it. I'm actually just stopping in Seligman really quick to come back here to Angel and Vilma's Route 66 gift shop, where Angel Delgadillo, the founder of historic Route 66, still works as a barber sometimes.
It's because I realized last night that I do not have a Route 66 sticker on my laptop.
And where better to get a Route 66 sticker than at the birthplace of historic Route 66?
If you want to know more about this, go back to my other videos, because we've been here before.
Just like I'm sure we'll be here again.
Pretty fascinating story. So much goodness, yes.
I'm pretty stoked whenever I'm able to buy even the smallest little trinkets from the authentic Route 66 places.
Check this out. I got a sticker. Angel and Vilma's original Route 66 gift shop. That is really cool. Then there's also one of those Route 66 pins of the barbershop.
I think collecting Route 66 pins is way more epic than collecting Disney pins, because
you kind of actually have to come out here to get them.
Which, like, the Disney pins, there's just a billion of them now. So where do you start? Where do you end? With the Route 66 ones, like, oh, I went there, I got the pin. See this pin? I've been to that place.
Well, I'm hoping to take Allie to the Grand Canyon at some point before the end of the year. So hopefully we'll be back in Seligman again really soon.
At the moment, though, there's a thunderstorm coming. So I'm gonna take that as a sign that I better keep moving along.
All right, heading a little further on down the road here. Wow, this stuff is cool. I've never seen this before.
The great thing about Route 66 is that there's so much to see.
The problem with Route 66 is that there's so much to see.
This is Ash Fork, Arizona, Flagstone capital of the world.
I just got off the interstate down there and was cruising down this little road, mostly because I've never been down it before, which is the best reason I know for going down any road, honestly.
When I noticed this sign over here, you can hear in the background some thunder. Ooh. There it is.
Gnarly thunderstorms up ahead, the direction that I'm going in.
So I thought, okay, why not wrap up the video by checking out a town I've never seen when I noticed this sign.
That's what I love about Route 66. There's little museums everywhere.
It looked a little strange to me here coming in to this little barely paved area.
But lo and behold, look at this Ash Fork, Arizona tourist center and museum.
This is so cool. See, if I hadn't taken that right turn because of that janky little sign back there, I would have never even known this was here.
I have no idea what this building used to be back in the day, but check out what's inside of it now.
Come on inside.
And take a look at this.
How flipping cool is this?
Look at this place. This is all stuff donated by locals.
Ash Fork is barely even a town now, but at one time, it was a major stop on the railroad, and they had a big Harvey House, the Hotel Escalante, which I think was demolished in 1968.
But like many other towns, there was life here before Route 66.
I love places like this, filled with creepy mannequins and weird homemade dolls. Old railroad lanterns, and look at old luggage. Places like this are so awesome.
See, other people say they wish that they had my YouTube skills. I wish I had this guy's model making skills.
Normally I'm pretty okay with mannequins. I'm getting more and more used to them the more museums I go into. This one over here,
this one keeps getting me every time. I keep thinking that's real.
I don't know why.
And every time I see this dude out of the corner of my eyes,
I'm pretty sure that one is haunted.
Anyway, this place is so cool. I don't have much time to stop in here and look at everything in detail, but I didn't want to leave you guys hanging and not show you
this amazing signature horse.
Plus, I wanted you guys to meet this young lady. Hello there.
I see that you have a whip. That's nice. Talk to you later.
Look at this homemade Route 66 quilt.
That's friggin' cool. I want a Route 66 quilt. Look at that.
This exhibit here is a real pain in the neck.
Whoa. Apparently they used to practice frontier justice in Ash Fork.
I wouldn't want to be a lawbreaker here.
Ooh. Old tools and old typewriters and old printing presses?
Yeah, check this out. It's an old printing press. I've never seen one like this.
I took printing classes in college, but I've never seen anything like that.
Pretty cool, and coolest of all is this model of the town of Ash Fork during the Route 66 heyday.
Look at this. This reminds me of Mr. Rogers' neighborhood or something. This is the coolest thing that I've seen in a while.
Not just because the model is amazing, and it is. Look at it.
You have models of all of these actual Route 66 businesses that were in the town, complete with little Route 66 signs and little props and background scenery.
But also for each one of the model buildings,
there are photographs of the actual buildings in the town. So you can see Zettler's Market in the heyday of Route 66, and you can see it right now. That right there is very, very cool.
I'm stuttering because it's just, that's such a good idea.
Dang, every Route 66 town should do this. Look at that. Look at that building in the background there. Is that building right there today? Right here you have DeSoto's Beauty and Barber Shop. Clearly back in the day, it was a Texaco.
Dude, I would love to see one of these for Seligman and Williams and every other Route 66 town. That'd be so cool.
Look, today in town is this church. Used to be the Arizona Cafe Bar. Look at that.
Then look at that.
Then look at that. That is so cool.
There really needs to be a place like this for every town. I wasn't expecting this town to have a place like that.
Look at these dapper gents right there. That's so cool.
Hey, this fire truck here looks familiar.
That's this fire truck. Okay, that's cool.
The coolest part is the guy running this place told me that I'm allowed to touch everything.
Allowed to touch the Model T touch.
Allowed to touch the ladder.
Allowed to give this guy in the cool Jeep a high five gently. Very gently.
Oh, look, it's old Pipe Hands McGillicuddy. She's still here after all this time.
Touching the saddle.
Ooh, she's touching the saddle too, you old toucher you.
I could touch this barbed wire over here, but I'm not going to.
Not gonna make that mistake again.
I would touch the gun, but Jimberly's voice is in my head. Don't touch my gun.
This place is so cool.
You better not be cheating again, Harry.
Cheating? I ain't never done no cheating in my
life.
Sure,
you're always cheating six ways to Sunday.
You better take that back now before I get rough.
Now settle down, you two, before it gets ugly.
Ugly? I'll show you boys ugly.
Calm down now, calm down.
Poker is fun.
Oh, great.
Now I'm in jail for firing the gun. Well, guys, if you like these videos and want to keep the show on the road, you can donate $1 a month at patreon.com/justinscars.
Or get one of my cool hats and t-shirts at livefastdiepoor.spreadshirt.com.
Make sure to subscribe for some more adventures. I'll see you guys later in Random Land.
Can you guys tell someone to please bring me bail money? Thanks.
Turns out the jail wasn't locked. They'll never take me alive.
I lose more criminals that way.
Well, don't worry, boss. We'll catch them later.
How are we gonna do that?
I subscribe to his YouTube channel.
We're dummies.